welcome to this cabinet vision tutorial. My name is Tayla, and today we're going to be looking at wall ends, what they are, and how they can save you a lot of time in your drawing process. Personally, I love wall ends. I use them in every single room that I draw because they save me a lot of time as I'm flicking between my plan and my elevation views while I'm designing and drawing. In this kitchen here, I'm going to show you how to turn them on and why they're great. So you can see this kitchen is a pretty standard setup, but there is quite a lot of walls. I counted them up and there's 9 walls in this room. But you can see the only walls that actually have cabinets attached to them is this back wall here where the hot plate is, the side wall here where the fridge is, and my island peninsula wall. All these other walls are important to include in my design, but I don't need to see them in my elevation as I'm designing the room. So if right now I was to go to elevation, I have 9 walls to choose from. Wall number 1 is completely blank. And so say I'm looking at wall number 4, which is the hot plate wall that I actually need to use, but then I want to move around to the fridge wall or to the island, I have to go through all the unused walls that I don't need to see to be able to flick in between them. Whereas if we make some of those walls that we don't need to see wall ends, they're not going to appear automatically on our elevation view, which will save us a lot of time clicking in between. So to do that, all you need to do is just click on the wall that you don't need to see in your elevation. And over on the side here where it says type, you've got this wall end function. And instead of no, make that a yes by double clicking. So I'm just going to go through and do that to all the walls that I don't need to be seeing. It's super easy to undo as well. If you ever add cabinets to that wall, you just come back in and switch it from yes to no. So now, if I go to my elevation, I come up on the hot plate wall. And if I want to get to the fridge wall, it's just one arrow click, and there is my fridge wall. And again to the island, one arrow click, and there's my island. And back again. So now I only have this list of 3 walls that are going to pop up in my elevations, which just saves me tons of time flicking in between. It's super easy to do, and once you set it up for the room, it's done. It saves you a lot of time. So yeah, use your wall ends and you will notice the difference that it makes to your ease of your process of design. If you have any questions about wall ends or any other things like that, please drop them below, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a cabinet vision power user.